Abdullah Mlokhiya, professor of pharmacy, former chairman of the National Organization for Drug Control in Egypt, and now vice president for research at Farco Pharmaceuticals. No, I have been attending the FET over the past 10 years. I come here every year. I see it now as a major pharmaceutical event that takes place in the Middle East area. The attendance and the participation by societies, international societies from all over the world, from America, from Europe, Australia, to be part of this. I see presidents of associations and accreditation of schools of pharmacy attending this. This is a very reputable conference and has a wide acceptance among the pharmacists at large. Today I talked about a problem that we are facing at different healthcare sites, the drug shortages. Now we are finding that a patient walks in drugstore and asks for his or her drug and not finding it. The pharmacist at the drugstore say, oh, it isn't short. This is a simple answer to the patient, is the most hurting answer to the patient, and it's hurting our practice. We are doing our job to make sure that drugs are available and affordable to all patients for every disease. If we talk about patients that are suffering from chronic illness like hypertension or diabetes, these patients are titrated on certain drugs and they know they take one pill or two pills a day, morning and evening, and all of a sudden that drug is not there. So they have to check with their doctors, change the medication and go after monitoring of their event. So this is a very alarming event. It is happening. It is not only the responsibility of the industry as the patients at large may think of, but it is responsibility of the industry as well as the regulatory and the suppliers, you know, because industry now is different from before than before. Industry now is outsourcing part of its job, is depending on suppliers of raw materials from different countries in the world. So the lines are long, the supply chain is long, and the vulnerability is increasing. I really was very happy with the attendance. The hall was almost full, and this is the first time to see such a number attending the lecture.